Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. I hope you all are doing good. In this video, I will show you how to make good looking social media animations for your YouTube videos in Wondershare Filmora. If you do not have Wondershare Filmora or if you simply want to use these animations in your YouTube videos, you can directly download them from the description without having to watch the full video. However, if you want to learn to make your own custom social media animations, make sure to watch the rest of the video. Let us now begin without wasting any further time. So to make a social media animation, you only need one thing. That is the logo of the application for which you want to make the animation. I'll provide the link to a number of social media icons. You can download it from there. In this video, I'll be making 4 animations for Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Discord. After downloading these icons, go to the title section and add any random title to the timeline. And double click on it and go to the advanced settings. Now delete this existing title and click on add image option and select the icon of any application that you want to make an animation of. I'll choose Instagram first. Then adjust the scale and position of the icon till you get the best result. Now click on add shape option and select this rectangular element right here. After that, place this rectangular element below the Instagram icon like this. Now clear the text and uncheck this box and then scroll down and uncheck the shape border option as well. Then choose a color for this rectangular shape. For now, I'll simply choose white color, but you can also make it look even better by adding a gradient color to the shape, something like this. Also, you can make it look slightly curved at the ends like this, or you can also keep it as a solid rectangle. After giving it a good color, adjust and play around with the size and position of the rectangular box to finally make it look something like this. Now the next step is to add your username inside this box. For that, just click on add text option and place it over the text box like this. Then type your username and give it a good color and most importantly a good font. So fetch through all the fonts and select the one that looks the best to you. After all this, the final step is to add an animation to this. For that, simply click on this animation option. And let us first choose an animation for the Instagram icon. You can choose any animation that looks good to you, but I'll choose this fade animation for the icon. Then choose an animation for the rectangular shape. Again, you can choose any animation, but I'll go for this one. Let us now choose an animation for the username. I'll select this one. So after you're done with adding animations to all these elements, you simply have to adjust the starting and the end time of these animations for all the 3 elements. Make sure that you don't mess up this part. Take your time to adjust the timings of these animations. Watch it over and over again. Make sure that the transition from one element to the other is smooth, something like this. Eventually, your animation is ready to use. All you have to do is export it as a transparent media file. I'll show you how. Click on export and then select this GoPro Cineform option. Now, type a name for the file and then choose a location. After that, click on settings and choose the encoder as CFHD alpha. Then set the resolution and other video settings depending upon your requirement. Finally, click on OK and click export and that's it. You now have an Instagram animation with a transparent background that you can use anywhere. If you have an older version of Filmora and if you don't have this GoPro Cineform option, you can make these animations in a default project file for all your YouTube videos. And whenever you have to make a new video, you can start editing in this project file itself. Meaning, just make your animations and save the project file. Then if you're planning to make a new YouTube video, just import all the media files of that video in this project file. And while editing your YouTube video, you can simply drag this title to the layer above the main media files. Similarly, I'll just give a quick glance of the other 3 social media animations. Check it out. If you still didn't understand this or if you have some doubts, you can join the channel's Discord server and I'll help you there personally, or you can also follow me on Instagram and leave a message. And if you want me to personally make a social media animation for you, then you can place your order on fiverr.com. The link will be given in the description. So that's it for the video. I hope this video was beneficial to you, and if it was, do not forget to hit the like button, subscribe to this channel and share the video with your YouTube friends. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye.